Jake the Snake Roberts, one of the premier athletes here in the World Wrestling Federation. And of course, every week he conducts a snake pit. And you will be most happy, Brain, to hear that we're going to have a good referee here in the World Wrestling Federation. An enforcer.
Danny Davis has been reinstated.
No. But I'm sure that you'll be surprised and you'll be happy about it. And Danny Davis, incidentally, will never be reinstated. So right now, yeah, whatever, take your calls, do whatever you want to do. We'll just continue on. Let's go to our special report.
Going through life, you got to remember something, folks, and that is, if you want to see the light, it's up to you. It is up to you to push the clouds out of the way. Now, my guest this evening, you know, I've had hundreds of guests on the snake pit since I've started conducting these, and I've asked them a lot of questions. But undoubtedly, my guest tonight is the most interesting man, probably one of the most bizarre men I've ever had on the pit. And he's a very famous man, a very well-respected man. So respected, in fact, that the WWF and Mr. Tunney has licensed this gentleman. I'm talking about Mr. T. How are you tonight, Bob?
Pretty good, pretty good, Jake.
So, I've been told that you've been licensed, but maybe you'd like to enlighten these people on the license that you have got.
Well, they called me in to take care of business in the ring, to be the enforcer. Because the referees that you've been having for the job don't know what they're doing. They've been no wrestling school. They don't know nothing. You get these guys from volleyball, tennis, little league baseball. These guys never been in a wrestling match. And so they don't know what they're doing. So the way I got ready for this here, I've been chopping down trees so I can handle these big wrestlers. So I'll be ready in there to take care of business. So no more Mr. T, I'll be Mr. E. I'll be enforcing the rules in the ring.
So you're not going to call yourself a referee. You're going to be the so-called enforcer.
Right, the enforcer. I'll be taking care of the business. If a guy's wrong, if I disqualify a wrestler, I'm throwing him out the ring. If he give me a hard time, I'll put him in a full Nelson. Kick his butt, throw him out back side.
Maybe that's what we've been looking for all along, is a referee like that, because you see, we have wrestlers that are just like this right here. They're just like snakes. You know what I mean?
I know what you mean.
Hey, what are you doing, man? Hold on. I didn't invite him out here, brother. I didn't invite this fool out here. What do you want?
Who do you think you are? Coming out here, give yourself a license to referee. When they took my license, the best referee the World Wrestling Federation has ever seen away from me. You ain't at home chopping down trees. You're in here with men, big men, over 6 foot tall, well over 400 pounds, and they're liable to kick your butt.
I'm gonna tell you something, Danny. You wasn't nothing as a ref. You ain't nothing as a wrestler. So I'm not here wasting my time. You know, I spend a lot of time chopping down trees. You nothing but a little shrub.
Oh, you're a shrub, huh?
Let me tell you something. I may be just a guy to kick your butt.
You know, hold it, Danny. If a guy's got his back to you, I mean, if you want something, all you gotta do is grab it, because you don't turn your back on a man that you're afraid of. And he's telling me that he ain't afraid of you. I mean, go ahead, take a shot, man. I mean, it's your life, right? Or maybe you just like to look at this, huh? What better man to run the rules, to make it go the way it's supposed to go, to have this man standing there and saying yes or no, we'll get the job done.
The new enforcer indeed in the World Wrestling Federation ranks of the referee.
I'm shaken.
You're not happy?
Guy comes out there with 600 pounds of cheap gold jewelry on, that's probably made of tin, starts playing with a shock absorber, and he's supposed to intimidate everybody? He better stay back there.
They're chopping down some trees, too.
Yeah, I bet they're not even 3 feet off the ground. I'll tell you something, he gets up in my face, I'll hit him so hard he'll grow hair where he doesn't have any.
I'll tell you a guy that's intimidating in my book, a guy that's making a return here to the World Wrestling Federation in a very unique manner. I'm referring to the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase.
You got your price.
And you got your price.
I know my price.
I know you know your price, and it's not
very
much.
Everybody's got their price. He's right. You do, too.
It's not dollars and cents, Brain, like it is with you. Everything with you is dollars and cents.
No, it isn't.
Some people have other values. But Ted DiBiase is doing a very strange thing.
I'll take bonds, security.
He's actually
property,
trying to dehumanize
a good
the
car,
public out there, and I don't like the way he's going about it. Let's go to the footage.
Maybe a free trip.
Everybody has a price. Everybody has a price. Everybody has a price. For the Million Dollar Man, yes, That's my motto. But all of you people out there still don't believe that you can be bought. But as time goes on, I'm going to prove it to you. I'm also going to prove to you that I am the most talented, the most gifted athlete that has ever set foot in the World Wrestling Federation. And right now, I'm also the hungriest. Virgil, lunch!
Ted Dibiase.
I'm sorry, sir. Nothing open. It will be about 30 minutes, 25, 30 minutes.
Look, you don't understand. I'm Ted Dibiase. I'm the million-dollar man. I don't wait in line for anybody.
Yes, sir. I have a full dining room. People waiting online. I really can't do anything right now. It will be 25 minutes.
You're sure you don't have a table?
Thank you, but I cannot do anything right now. I'm going to upset the people and look at the dining room.
Virgil?
I cannot find a table at all.
I'm sure you can find a table.
I will. Actually, there is 25, maybe 20 minutes, but that's the best I can do.
Virgil, look, okay. I don't care about your regular customers. I don't care if you have to kick somebody out of their seat. I want a table now.
Okay, sir. Okay, let me see what I can do then. Thank you.
That's what I thought.
What's the deal, man? Can't you wait in line like everybody else?
Hey, don't be upset with that maitre d' for giving me a seat. He didn't do anything that any one of you wouldn't have done. He had his price, just like each and every one of you has your price. Everybody's got a price for the million-dollar man.
How despicable. I'll take jewelry, diamonds.
Oh, you're easy. You're easy. You don't have
you're
to
put
wait.
On earth here to make a living and enjoy yourself.
Everyone's put on this earth for a purpose.
Right.
Mine's even if to be money. A horrible example.
Oh, you're too hard on yourself.
No, I'm talking about you and guys like Ted DiBiase.